Hello, peasants. Today we're going to be doing, finally, after a long wait, I know I've been too busy looking at myself in the mirror, we're going to finally do Ask Commodus, where you guys submit questions and I answer them. Let's get to them. First question comes from Nana Clow, and he wants to know, you what, mate? A nice question comes from Levi Siech, and he wants to know, what is a Roman spectacle? Before I answer your question, I have to say that you look an awful lot like me, and that is indeed a compliment. You are looking fine, my dude. But to answer your question, a Roman spectacle is basically a very fundamental part of Roman culture and life. There were two types of Roman spectacles. There was privately held games called the Munera, and then there was the publicly held games, which were called the Ludi. So the earliest games that were held were the Ludi Circensis, and these were the chariot racing games. But then we also had the Venetians, which were beast hunting games, and then there is also my personal favorite, the gladiatorial games. Next question comes from Jolene Aislin, and she wants to know what impact the celebration of violence has had on Rome. The celebration of violence has only had a positive impact on Rome. In fact, I encourage violence. I think it's socially acceptable, nay, necessary, for myself and the upper class to assault the lower class. Besides, violence is inevitable. We basically have a non-existent police force, and 30% of the population are slaves. So, I mean, I'd like to interrupt the video at this point to make it known that the O Holy Siobhan, praise her name, has graced our video with her presence, and her question is, thank you for your question, what's my problem with ostriches? If it isn't an insult, I might ask that you would refer to my Draw My Life video. If it's not too much work, I don't want you to be putting in too much work. But if it's no trouble at all, you can refer to my last video, which I will link in the description down below, and you can check that out, and the answer will be there. Thank you for gracing this video with your presence. Our next question comes from Jay Wu, and she wants to know why I don't drive my chariot around in public. The reason I don't do that is because I admit it's a bit improper for a man of my status to demean himself to the level of a charioteer, who of course has the legal status of a prostitute. Though it should be noted, I do believe that my sexual prowess is of monetary value. I just like to keep my sexual life and my charioteering life separate. Besides, I actually like to drive around in the moonlight. There's something so hauntingly beautiful about doing so. Next question comes from Shiloh Shay, and she wants to know, what's up with the ginger hair? Well, let me tell you, first of all, that my luscious ginger hair should be revered for its uniqueness and should not be associated with Satan or his evil powers, for I'm not evil at all. I should just be glad that I don't have blonde hair, because that is the color of hair associated with prostitutes. Paul's John wants to know what reforms I've overseen during my time ruling, and he wants to know what the purpose of those reforms were. Well, Paul's John, people are idiots, and people spend too much money on games. So, back when my dad was still alive, him and I implemented a rule which standardized the cost of games, so people couldn't spend so much money on the games. Paul's John also wants to know who would win in a fight to the death, Joaquin Phoenix or Russell Crowe? Now, despite what Ridley Scott might say in his depiction of my life, Joaquin Phoenix would win. Simple as that. Vanessa Vendrasco, Aries Styles of One Direction, wants to know what sets me apart from past emperors and emperors to come. I think my biggest distinction, the thing that sets me apart most, is my good looks. I don't think there's ever been an emperor who looks quite as good as me, or one who will ever come that looks as good as me. But apart from that, I would say my second biggest distinguishing attribute would be my love to fight in the arena. I don't think there's ever been a gladiator who loved as much as me destroying plebs and animals in the arena. And I don't think anyone will ever be able to beat my grand slam of killing an elephant, lion, and a hippo. Beat that, Caligula! Isabop Come Hither notes that recently I implemented a new tax, and she wants to know what percent of the money from that tax I'm going to dedicate to gladiatorial games. Well, Isabop, I'm going to dedicate 50% of the money towards gladiatorial wages. The other 50%, let's put towards Venetians. Yeah. Who cares about, you know, comfort, seating? Be grateful, okay? So Farzad Falafel wants to know what I find so entertaining about the gladiatorial games. Imagine a Canucks game, except the hockey sticks are swords, and everybody wants to kill each other. So what's not so entertaining about the gladiatorial games? Falafel also wants to know what types of gladiators there are. Though I'm not going to list all of them for you because I want you to do your individual research, one of the most common pairings is a secutor, who is a heavily armed soldier, versus the retiarius, and he has a net and a trident. There is also the mermillo, who has a big shield, and the thracian, who has a small shield. So Jay Quellen wants to know, what's the scoop with my dad? Basically, Jay Quellen, rumor has it that my mom had an affair with a gladiator, which means that I must not be the son of my dad. And which also means I have gladiatorial blood running through my veins. I'll take it. Jacob You Don't Surf wants to know one way in which Joaquin Phoenix's portrayal of me in Gladiator was accurate, and one way in which it was inaccurate. One way in which it was accurate is that I am a little bit mentally unstable, and I think Joaquin Phoenix portrayed that well. When I'm in the arena, I fear condemnation and laughter from the crowds. One way in which I think he portrayed me inaccurately is that in the movie, he's depicted killing his father, and I would never kill my father. Not with my own hands anyways. Don't like to get these babies dirty. So Kim Possible wants to know if it's true that I renamed the 12 months of the year to correspond with my 12 names. It is true, I did that. So for example, August is now Commodus, September is Hercules, Rome is my colony, and no, I'm not a megalomaniac, I'm simply just possessive. So Johannesburg Kim wants to know if you can sit wherever you want in the Colosseum. No, idiot, you can't sit wherever you want, obviously, duh. My boy Gus, way back in the day, aka Augustus, he set up the seating such that the seating arrangement would be aligned with the moral code of Rome. For instance, you had females at the back, you had people with dark togas at the back, and then you had your boys, the senators, at the front. So Segway Seb wants to know, what's my favorite use of gladiator sweat, and how should he use it? I mean, there's a lot of different uses. You can use it however you want. However, most Roman dermatologists suggest that you bathe in it for at least 3 hours for the best results. Catherine Ow wants to know what my favorite part is about ruling autonomously. Probably that I get to party every night without my dad over my shoulder. I also get more freedom when I'm putting on gladiatorial games, so I mean, that's good too. Dingbat Pennyloafer has posed a question regarding physics. The problem with this is that the laws of physics don't apply to me. I'm a divine and celestial being. But if I had to answer this question, I would say that I would catch the arrow while simultaneously destroying the lion. I would then take the arrow and gouge out the eyes of the lion and use those eyes as bath salts in my gladiatorial sweat bath. So that just about sums up the video. Thank you everybody very much for submitting questions. I'm sorry I couldn't get to all of them. Naturally, there were a lot of questions and I was struck for time, but nonetheless, I appreciate you guys submitting them. The great Siobhan, at her own discretion, will give you guys bonus marks for the questions that you submitted. So yeah, thank you again. But before I go, I have one last question, and this question comes from Maximus Meridius, and he asks this.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained? Is this not why you are here?
Turn the music up, turn me down. Google. Let's go get him again. This time is for the money, my nigga. Brooklyn, stand up. Never been a nigga this good for this long, this hood, or this pop, this hot, or this strong, with so many different flows. This one's for this song, the next one I switch up. This one will get bit up. These fucks too lazy to make up shit. They crazy, they don't paint pictures, they just trace me. You know what? Soon they forget where they pluck. They whole style from the try to reverse the outcome. I'm like, cuck. I'm not a biter, I'm a writer for myself and others. I say a big verse, I'm only big enough, my brother. Big enough.